Meeting of Shreveport City Council is now called to order. Administrative conference. I will give the invocation, and Grayson, would you lead? Councilman Butcher, I'm sorry.
Yes, sir.
Would you lead and pledge allegiance? Let us pray. Father God, we thank you for this day, and we thank you for this city, and we pray, oh God, that we will be compassionate toward helping our fellow man, and we will do those things which are righteous. God, help us to be the shining light on the hill. I pray forgiveness of our sins. I pray that you will help be with the sick and the afflicted. Pray for the hungry, for those that are in the cold. Now, God, go with us and guide us and help us to rejoice in thy name. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
If you would, face the flag and repeat after me. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk, will you please call the roll?
Councilwoman Taylor?
Present.
Councilwoman Fuller? Councilman Nicholson?
Present.
Councilman Butcher?
Here.
Councilman Flores?
Here.
Councilman Green?
I'm here.
And Councilman Bowman.
Tomorrow, with great enthusiasm, I will be entertaining a motion to approve the minutes of the Monday, October 25th, 21 administrative conference, and the Tuesday, the 26th city council meeting, and a Thursday, November the 4th special meeting. Does a council member at this time have any awards and recognitions or distinguished guests not to exceed the 15 minutes? You do?
Yes. Okay. And please, all requests to speak forms are due at this time, so make sure that you turn them in at 3 o'clock at the top of the hour if you choose to speak. We have with us today Robert Superman Blunt. Come on down. You're the next contestant at the City Council Administrative Conference.
Hey, Robert. Hey, Robert.
City Attorney Latia, how are you? Ready?
You can go right ahead. It's the fifth for life.
All right. Thank you. First of all, I want to thank the mayor's office and this great council for all your support and all the things that you've done to help us build a viable ministry. The Fit for Life Ministries Incorporated, and the things that we've done would be virtually impossible without your support of the city. But what I did was, after we do all these events and things that we are part of during the city, a lot of these things is what you are funding. A lot of you all never have an opportunity to come to them. So I bought a video, about 2 minutes, 30 seconds, to give you all a great idea of the things that we're doing in the community and what you're helping to support us with, and you'll see the economic impact also. After the video, any questions you might have, any statements you'd like to make, something that I can address, I'd be more than happy to. Okay? Where's Connie?
She's coming.
Okay. It was booted up to go, but I'll let Connie before I mess it up.
Here they come. They're going to be there.
Stop.
Thank you. So these are the things that we're doing throughout the city yearly. And again, we could not do it without your support. And I just wanted to thank you all for all that you're doing to help us. One of the biggest things we're pushing is the wellness and fitness. You notice we started from little kids playing and having fun, all the way to bodybuilding and wellness, at the epitome of health and wellness. The key is to reach everybody, because right now being fit is no longer an option. You can't sit back and say, I'm gonna get to it later. It just doesn't work that way anyway. We're in a place now where fitness is no longer an option. It's a necessity. So again, I wanna thank you. Any questions? Tabcat, what you smiling at? Any questions or things that you might want to say, I'd be more than happy to answer.
Superman, I actually want to just thank you for all that you have done for this community for years. Well, I won't say for years, for decades. I mean, you were renowned, known for your weightlifting and bodybuilding. You decide to come back home and basically enhance and embrace our community with Fit for Life. You have this competition that comes and brings so many of them to the area. So I would just encourage everybody that when he has the Fit for Life weekend, you should go, because it is rather amazing.
Thank you. Thank you.
Always a pleasure to see you, Mr. Superman.
Thank you, Councilman. Thank you.
Yeah, I can go in his gym. It's right downtown.
Why are you looking at me?
I'm just saying.
I lost 27 pounds under that man. So thank you, Superman.
Thank you so much. Thank you all. Thank
work.
You.
I promise you, you're going to work.
Yeah, you're
you going to work now.
You're going to work.
That's true. That's right. Thank you so much.
Thank you so
yes,
much.
Yes, ma'am. Thank
See you,
you
at church Sunday.
Thank you. I look forward to it.
Yes,
sir.
Yes.
Any other guests? Okay. Mayor Perkins' office, do y'all have any?
No, sir.
Okay. Does any member have questions relative to proper standards for Mr. T. Green, Terrence Green? Okay, Mr. Green, there's silence up here, so you've done a great job, covered everything. Thank you very much. What about in reports, revenue collection plan, implementation? Report tomorrow? Okay. Is that a yes? Please, let me have a yes,
yes
or no.
Yes, sir, you will have it. Yes, sir.
Thank you. All right, will there be a surety bond? Reports tomorrow, yes or no?
No, sir.
Okay. All right, we have a public hearing tomorrow. We are required to hold a public hearing on ordinance number 177 of 2021. Mr. Whitehorn, would be any legislation be added tomorrow?
None that I'm aware of.
Okay, now we changed up, for the record, Councilman Green, we changed up public comments. On today we speak on non-agenda and agenda items, or we either have no request to speak, but you use the work conference today to do those things of agenda or non-agenda. Tomorrow, it'll be strictly agenda items, correct, Mr. Green?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Can we have two public comments?
Okay, we have two, and the Vice Chair will control the time.
Dr. Joseph Carter. You can just state your name, sir. We already have your address for the record.
Joseph Carter, 166 Hallett Drive, Shreveport, Louisiana, 7115. Good afternoon. Honorable Mayor Perkins in his absence, and his staff, and honorable council members, I am Joseph Carter, a retired Caddo Parish teacher, counselor, principal, and educator. I also served as an adjunct instructor at Centenary College and directed the Wiley College Management Institute at Wiley College. When I retired from Caddo Schools in 1998, I was a non-golfer who received many golfing items for gifts. For 2 years, they remained dormant. I began doing some driving range and some following up instructions, but I wasn't really committed. However, 2 years later, I was recommended to do the first tee life skills for the first tee program of Northwest Louisiana. After approximately 4 years of volunteering, my interest in golf became a little bit more serious. I began paying annual membership fees to play at Shreveport courses that later became semi-annual. However, beginning in 2018, seniors could continue their current membership if fees were paid prior to December 31st. If you were grandfathered in and paid back annually, you could continue your membership after December 31st, but with an additional fee. I'm requesting on behalf of the senior golfers that there be consideration for a reduction in the fees. This request is not for free golf for seniors, but consideration for reduced annual membership fee to be given consideration for these seniors who have paid taxes for most of their adult lives, who have supported tax and bonding propositions, and have paid annual fees to play golf. What I would recommend for consideration, a golfer who reaches the age of 75 pays 75% of the annual senior rates. A golfer that reaches the age of 80 pays 50%. A golfer that reaches the age of 85 pays 25%. And a golfer that reaches the age of 90, whatever is recommended. The few grandfathered in members who pay semi-annually pay two equal payments with no surcharge added to those payments.
Dr. Gordon, your time is up, sir. So what you want us to do is to look at reducing the fees for seniors with golf?
Yes, I would like for you to look at this applies to golfers who have continued uninterrupted membership with no break in service for weekday greens and carts usage.
You can rest assured you have my support 110%.
Thank you. Are there any other questions? Thank you again.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Carter.
I have for the mayor, the chief administrative officer, and each council member a folder that covers some communications I have done over the last 2.5 years regarding the same topic with persons who have led the golfing for the city of Shreveport at the various courses and at the administrative level.
Okay.
Who may I give these to? Are there any other questions?
Thank you, sir. Marvin Muhammad.
Marvin Muhammad, to the council, three quick items that I want to speak on. First of all, I want to speak on the importance of Councilman Nicholson and City Councilwoman Taylor joint legislation that struggled to be passed just 2 weeks ago. Just recently in the MLK community at the address of 1750, the former Wright Gray. There's a request made to the state of Louisiana ABO office to give that location another liquor license. I was under the impression, and I hope we look into this, that location wouldn't be able to be licensed in the future for at least a year. I think it was. Hopefully we can look at that, and hopefully we don't have a situation where if the state gives them that license, that they don't start selling alcohol and play dumb before going through the city. I also want to speak again, because I probably won't be here tomorrow. I want to speak briefly again on the resolution that Councilman Green introduced. And I believe that the city of Shreveport owes CL Concepts an apology. The federal government in 1935, they passed the 1935 Miller's Act, which governs surety bonds between the federal government and contractors. The state of Louisiana did the same. It's called the Little Miller's Act that governs, again, the relationship between contractors and those who are wishing to do business with the state. In the city of Shreveport, despite not having legislation, this body decided to put that burden on the entity. What shocks me is that we believe that is okay when there hasn't been a standard established. From my research, CL Concept is the only entity that's doing business with the city of Shreveport that has over forced to get a performance or payment bond. Ridiculous. I believe she's owed an apology from the city. And lastly, I want to speak upon the legislation that Councilwoman Taylor is introducing up and down the North Market corridor. She is introducing a TIF. As you know, last year this time, but we now have Amazon, the $200 million capital improvement project.
Mr. Muhammad, on the liquor ordinance, that court case, if I'm not mistaken, for the suspension of their address is in litigation, correct? So we're looking into that as well regarding that, because we're not in support of any new liquor stores coming within that area, especially at that location with everything that has been there at that point.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. We have no executive appointments to be considered tomorrow. There are no items under consent agenda for induction or to be adopted. Mr. Whitehorn, would you please proceed with the regular agenda legislation?
Resolutions on second reading and final passage. Resolution 124 to establish an intergovernment committee. Resolution 128, approving an annual payment in lieu of tax in accordance with the Memorandum of Understanding between Shreveport Home Mortgage Authority and SPC Development, LLC. Resolution 131, authorizing the mayor to execute an agreement between the City of Shreveport and Unified Nonprofits, Inc. Resolution 132, authorizing the mayor to execute an option to ground lease between the City of Shreveport and Shreveport HP Allendale LLC. Resolution 133, authorizing the mayor to execute an option to ground lease between the City of Shreveport and Shreveport Millennium Housing 4 LLC. Resolution 134, authorizing the mayor to execute a corporate endeavor agreement between the City of Shreveport and the State of Louisiana Facility Planning and Control Division of Administration for the City of Shreveport District 3 Road Rehabilitation, Planning, and Construction. Resolution 135, to amend Resolution Number 87 of 2021, which was adopted to execute a contract between the City of Shreveport, Louisiana, and C. Edwards Concept, LLC, to to provide curbside recycling within the city, within the limits of Shreveport. Resolution 136, to repeal resolution number 238 of 2010, which requires the city attorney to provide a report concerning the collection of surety bond forfeitures at the first regular city council meeting on each month, and to otherwise provide with respect thereto. Resolution 137, to recognize Deputy Marshal Chasen, I believe I'm saying that right, Swan, and Deputy Marshal Lance Swan for their life-saving heroics in saving the life of a gunshot victim, and to otherwise provide with respect thereto. Resolution 138, a resolution in support of consenting to Cattle Parish creation of Amazon TIF District, State of Louisiana, wholly within the city limits of the city of Shreveport.
Mr. Chairman.
Yeah.
Mr. Chairman, Resolution 136, if adopted, will repeal the requirement that the city attorney make regular reports concerning surety bond forfeitures to the council. In the 3 years that I've served on the council, that report has neither been made nor has it been necessary. I conferred with the city attorney. He has no objection to this legislation. It will clean up our agenda just a bit. Thank you.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
On Resolution 132, I will be asking for a post. I'm sorry. Yes. 132, I'll be asking for a postponement on that resolution.
132?
Yes. Councilman Gutierrez, we have pretty much on the Intergovernmental Committee. We have all
that. Can't hear.
Well, on one, that's what I, Mr. Chairman, on 124, are y'all still looking into that? Okay. I also had a conversation with the parish the other day about this, and we may just table this until the first of the year, because there's some overlapping, I believe, that already happens with this, and the main goal of this intergovernment committee was to really be on crime and juvenile crime. And so I think tomorrow I'm going to move to table this until we can get some clarity from the city attorney and from Caddo Parish Commission.
Okay. Mr. Chair.
Yes, Councilman Green.
Tomorrow I'll ask that 135 be postponed.
Okay.
Can't hear.
135 tomorrow will be asked to be postponed. Councilman Green.
I ask your support on the TIF district on Resolution 138.
Okay. What about, I didn't quite. What did you say on 138?
Ask for your support.
Oh, yes. Councilwoman Taylor asked for support on 138. All right, any other discussion? Mr. Whitehorn, would you proceed with introduction of resolutions not to be adopted prior to December the 14th of 2021?
Resolution 139, authorizing the mayor to execute an agreement between the city of Shreveport and Carr Riggs and Ingram LLC for the purpose of an external audit of the city of for fiscal year January 2021 through December 31st, 2021. Resolution 140, authorizing the mayor to execute an acceptance of active donation and permanent utility servitude agreement between the city of Shreveport and Linwood Development LLC, herein called owner, and acting herein through Sammy A. Majalis, member manager, and for water mains and related facilities to serve Agent Majalis subdivision number 2.
Any discussion there? Mr. Whitehorn, would you proceed with the introduction of ordinances not to be introduced prior to December 14th of 2021?
Ordinance 184, amending the 2021 retained risk fund budget. Ordinance 185, amending the 2021 general fund budget. Ordinance 186, amending the 2021 general fund budget. Ordinance 187, amending the 2021 general fund budget. Ordinance 188, amending the 2021 capital projects fund budget, appropriating the funds authorized herein. Ordinance 189, amending the 2021 capital projects fund budget. Ordinance 190, amending the 2021 water sewer enterprise fund budget. Ordinance 191, declaring the city's interest in certain land surplus and our intentions to donate certain land acquired by the Department of Community Development to Volunteers of America of North Louisiana. Ordinance 192, to amend Chapter 38 of the Code of Ordinances relative to rental dwelling unit registration program. Ordinance 193, to amend various article and sections in the City of Shreveport, Louisiana Unified Development Code relative to rental dwelling units. Ordinance 193 is where it left off, to amend the various articles and sections of the City of Shreveport, Louisiana Unified Development Code relative to rental dwelling units, their registration, maintenance, and inspection. Ordinance 194, to amend the Metropolitan Planning Commission fee schedule for the City of Shreveport, Louisiana Unified Development Code relative to fees for rental dwelling unit registration program, as well as for garage sales. Ordinance 195, to amend Chapter 58, Article 4, Division 1 of Chapter 78, Article 7, Article 8, Division 1 of the City of Shreveport, Louisiana Code of Ordinances, relative to litter and dumping.
Mr. Whitehorn, in regards to 194, was you made aware that this was coming on the agenda? Did you have any discussion with MPC?
I know we discussed it in staff meeting this morning, yeah, about some of the rental dwellings. Okay. So that was discussed in our staff meeting this morning.
We could get in trouble on this one. In my opinion, we've had this in the past. When we go to charging folks for garage sales, churches, and things like that, we're going to get in trouble. That's for my opinion, for what it's worth. Yes. I'd like to hear from the other council members. Their concern may not be as where I'm at, but I know we've had that in years past. We tried to do things with garage sales and charge folks.
But I think there's a limit on... Is it not for each garage sale? It's only a minimum that you have, and if you go over that minimum, then is it a charge? Am I wrong? No.
Mr. Clark, you want to come and speak to the 194?
Yes, I'm certainly pleased to hear from Mr. Clark, but I don't understand this to impose a fee for garage sales.
It says as well as for garage sales. I mean, that's what I'm looking at.
Mr. Fleury, if you recall, we have never charged for garage sales, and this ordinance does not offer to charge for garage sales. It just creates a permit for, as Councilwoman Taylor was alluding to, it just creates a permit for garage sales in order for us to track the number of garage sales being conducted. You might remember there have been times when a particular citizen have had a garage sale every day, every week.
In my district.
and you wanted us to do something about it, and there was nothing we could do. But if we have this ordinance in place, and they just had to put the garage sale fee, but there's no fee associated, but there's a permit. If we and the UDC remove what you and I and others had put in place back in the day, and this is just putting it back into the ordinance.
Okay. Thanks for clearing that up.
Yes, sir.
Ms. Clark, what about plate lunches?
As long as you're selling them for free, Councilman Green, we don't have a problem with them.
I'm good, Mr. Chair.
All right, thank you. Mr. Whitehorn, you will proceed with ordinance on second reading and final passage.
Ordinance 123, declaring the city's interest in certain vacant land as surplus and other intentions to transfer certain vacant land to the Greater Shreveport Chamber of Commerce. Ordinance 149, amending section 10-69 of chapter 10, article 4, division 2 of the City of Shreveport, Louisiana Code of Ordinances with respect to the fee and terms of alcohol beverage handling employee cards. Ordinance 172, amending the 2021 general fund budget. Ordinance 173, amending the 2021 golf enterprise fund budget. Ordinance 174, amending the 2021 budget for the general fund. Ordinance 175, amending the 2021 budget for the Riverfront Development Fund. Ordinance 176, to revise Chapter 22, Article 2, Building and Building Regulation Standards of the City of Shreveport, Louisiana, Code of Ordinances, relative to the distance of private improvements to city infrastructure. Ordinance 177, authorizing the issuance of the amount of $5,675,000 of Revenue Bond Series 2021 of the City of Shreveport, State of Louisiana, prescribing the form, terms, and conditions of said bonds, designating the date, denominations, place of payment, and paying agent of said bonds, providing for the payment thereof and principal and interest, approving the form of the limited offering memorandum and bond placement agreement, and providing for other matters in connection therewith. Ordinance 178, an ordinance to amend various articles and sections of the City of Shreveport, Louisiana Unified Development Code relative to garage sales and their approval process. Ordinance 183, to amend section 66-141 of chapter 66, personnel, article 3, health benefits of the City of Shreveport Code of Ordinances relative to contributions by active employees and the city. Ordinance 124, zoning case number 21-76-C, an ordinance to amend the official zoning map of the City of Shreveport Unified Development Code by rezoning property located on the southwest corner of Malham Street and Arkansas Avenue, Shreveport, Caddo Parish, Louisiana, from C-1 Neighborhood Commercial District to C-3 General Commercial District. Ordinance 125, zoning case number 21-100-C, an ordinance to amend the official zoning map of the City of Shreveport Unified Development Code by rezoning property located on the southeast corner of Piermont Road and Willard Avenue, Shreveport, Caddo Parish, Louisiana, from R-1-7 Single Family Residential District to C-1 Neighborhood Commercial District. Ordinance 179, zoning case number 21-136-C, an ordinance to amend the official zoning map of the City of Shreveport Unified Development Code by rezoning property located on the northwest side of Shreveport Barksdale Highway at the intersection of Riley Lane, Shreveport, Caddo Parish, Louisiana, from C-2 Carter Commercial District to C-3 General Commercial District. Ordinance number 180, zoning case number 21-139-C, an ordinance to amend the official zoning map of the City of Shreveport Unified Development Code by rezoning property located on the north side of Gladstone Boulevard, approximately 260 feet west of Lyon Avenue, Shreveport, Caddo Parish, Louisiana, from R-2 Multifamily Residential District to C-UC Urban Corridor District. Ordinance 181, zoning case number 21-147C, an ordinance to amend the official zoning map of the city of Shreveport Unified Development Code by rezoning property located on the north side of East Stevenson Street, approximately 260 feet west of Beverly Place, Shreveport, Cattle Parish, Louisiana, from C1 Neighborhood Commercial District to R-2 Multifamily Residential District. Ordinance 182, zoning case number 21-148-C, an ordinance to amend the official zoning map of the city of Shreveport Unified Development Code by rezoning property located on the northwest corner of Juella Avenue and Woodrow Street, Shreveport, Cattle Parish, Louisiana, from C-2 Corridor Commercial District to C-3 General Commercial District.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes. Councilman Nicholas.
Mr. Letier, there have been several revisions of the cooperative endeavor agreement to transfer the old library to the Chamber of Commerce. Are you satisfied that what's on the agenda now appropriately protects the city's interest?
Correct.
Mr. Chairman, concerning Ordinance 149, we discussed at our last meeting the fact that if adopted, this legislation will increase the cost of that grocery store checkers and waiters and bartenders all have to pay to get an ABO card for $24 to $40. I think that's a fee increase that the city can do without, and so I hope that we will not adopt Ordinance 149.
140 what?
149. Well, the lady that sells you your beer at the grocery store, Mr. Chairman, she'll have to pay a bit more. He'll have to pay a bit more to get his ABO card every couple of years if we adopt this, and I just don't think we need to do that.
Okay.
And then.
What number was that?
149.
Yes,
149.
Second reading and final passage.
And then the final ordinance I'll just comment on briefly is the legislation on the agenda that would move some money around so that the city can make a donation or enter a cooperative endeavor agreement with LSU to the tune of $1 million. I just think before we actually enter that cooperative endeavor agreement, we ought to hear from LSU as to what they're going to do with the money.
They'll be here tomorrow.
Okay. And I'll just point out again that the state of Louisiana for the fiscal year ending in 2021 is projected to have a budget, perhaps has already calculated, a surplus of $1 billion. So we just need to have a public conversation about what we're doing with that money. Thank you.
Okay, any other council? Madam Clerk, is there any table legislation to be removed today?
Nothing.
All right, we have no property standards appeal. That we have MPC case number 21-101C appeal to consider tomorrow. Are there any other appeals, Madam Clerk?
No.
Are there any reports from officers, board, or committees to this afternoon? Madam Clerk, is there going to be a report, clerk's report?
Yes, we received an appointment for Greg Dunn to the DDA, Patrick Wesley to the Shreveport Voters Sports Commission Authority, and Alan Jackson to the Shreveport Voters and the Public Tourism Authority.
Okay. No executive session. If there's no other business, then this meeting. Is anybody?
I have one question.
Okay.
Chief Smith.
Good afternoon.
Saturday night, there was a shooting at the state fair. Have there been any conversations with the leadership out there? I know that there were some concerns about metal detectors, and then individuals wondering how firearms are entering the fair. It's a family event, and of course that scares any individual when you see somebody shot. At an event of that nature. So I just wanted to know, has there been conversations, what type of increased security measures are they taking? Is there anything else that we can do as a city to assist?
We are working in conjunction with the state fair officials to get more SPD personnel out there. As you well know, each year, from as long as I can remember, SPD has provided the security for the state fair. And I talked with Mr. Giordano Saturday night, late at length, and I happened to be there on the fairground when this occurred. And we did, in fact, have all of the entrances going into the fairground covered. And Mr. Giordano and the state fair officials had hired additional security, private security guards to be at each entrance, warning and searching, you know, for weapons. It's so unfortunate because of the size of the state fairground, fencing all over the place. There's just tons of ways that someone could, you know, infiltrate that barrier. But we did, in fact, have all the entrances covered, and we're going to work here in the future that hopefully maybe we can find some additional personnel and put someone actually patrolling all of the perimeter where possibly someone could infiltrate that already really, really strict barrier. So we're keeping in touch with him and going to do what we can to continue to make the state fair a safe place for all of us to be.
I know that another source of contention with the increased gun violence that we're seeing in our city, especially amongst our young people.
Yes.
And I know that you all are working with several other entities to try to remediate what you can when it comes to some certain level of gun control in the city, but there is some way or another that we're going to have to try to help calm our public in that sense, because we're constantly, that number is climbing, which doesn't make anybody feel good. So Chief, I think it's probably some conversations that we probably need to have with the DA as well. Oh God, I thought he was still here. To see what we could do. And I think that we're exploring some other opportunities on this council to take a look at, because what we don't want is a city in fear.
Yes, I agree with you 100%. And I mentioned to the CAO last week in our staff meeting, we're working on a proposal, and I think it's really, really gonna be beneficial to this city. And just to give you a little tips, and we're trying to work out the details of it, most young people have cell phones and they are really, really into social media and communicating electronically. So we're trying to develop an avenue in addition to Crime Stoppers, and I think this will help us out greatly, where young people or anyone, when they see something, when they know of something, when they suspect something, they can just text us the information, give us a little lead, and we can react immediately to try to prevent things from coming or happening without any such fear of anyone knowing who you are. So in other words, to give you an example, if someone in high school knows that or hears someone talking of bringing a weapon to high school, for giving an example, they can text us that information and we can get on top of it to try to prevent anything from happening. Same as what happened at the fairground. A lot of times someone knows or suspects all things that occurred, and if we can get in front of it and keep it from occurring, that's our best option.
There is a third thing, that's my last thing, another disturbing video that I received that occurred in my district that I'm concerned with some property owners that we have and what is allowed. I think that is unacceptable, intolerable, and quite dangerous for children who live in the area that I want to discuss. I understand that there are some arrests that have been made, but I am deeply, deeply concerned with the amount of ammunition that is centralized in one location. And so I think that even when we talk about, when we look at these renters codes, when we look at individuals that own property that allow this to happen, then there are some things that we need to look at as far as these property owners are concerned.
Oh, I can't agree with you more. That comes a time when I think the property owner needs to share some of the responsibility, as long as we make sure that they are fully aware that we're giving it our best effort. Now you know about it. Do what you can, you know, to help us. Without a doubt, I agree with you 100%. Okay.
Thank you so much, Chief. I appreciate it.
Yes, ma'am.
Chief, I want to make sure that every time you come before the council, I take the opportunity to reiterate our full support of you and our commitment to provide you whatever resources you need. If you tell us that there are resources you don't have that will help you fight crime, and in particular violent crime in this community, I'll push the yes button in front of me every time. I fully agree with Councilwoman Taylor's comments, and I'll just say, as I've said before, that our, in my opinion, particular focus in this city has got to be on violent gun crimes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
There has been in the past a great deal of focus on crimes that are offenses that there is not a great of threat to the public, and that's why I was pleased to join Councilwoman Taylor with our marijuana initiative.
Yes.
In state district court for many years, you could go down to the basement and look at dozens and sometimes hundreds of people charged with possessing a small quantity of marijuana, taking up officers' time for something that really was not harming the public. So I hope that we can refocus and reallocate resources to the fullest extent possible on these violent gun crimes. They are our city's most pressing safety problem. Thank you.
Thank you so much for that, Councilman. And that means so much to us and the men and women of the Shreveport Police Department. And immediately upon accepting this awesome responsibility for the safety of our community, I looked at what was our greatest concern, and I agree with 100% violence is. And we have done just like any other good football team would do. We have reallocated our resources. We have shifted our attention to focus more on violent crime, specifically gun violence crime. And we have had probably a dozen or so operations since I've been in this position where we've taken a lot of guns and a lot of illegal narcotics off the street. And I really, really feel that it's made an impact, and we're going to continue to push hard to do that. You know, it's one of those things where I couldn't exactly quantify and say the operation tonight that took 20 guns off of the street stopped this one person from getting harmed. But I can assure you those 20 guns will never have the opportunity to harm someone else. And we're going to continue to push hard to get weapons off the street, without a doubt. And the men and women of the police department are so eager and happy to have this council standing behind them as they move forward in doing so. And, you know, keep in mind that every day ain't going to be a good day. We're not going to be as completely and as successful on one day as we would another day. And another day ain't hardly anything going to go right. But that's not going to deter our determination to continue to make this city the safest that it can be.
Thank you, Chief.
I appreciate the Chief.
Anybody else? Okay.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, Councilman Green, what you are recognized.
What time is it?
I don't know. I'm looking back there, and it's 5 o'clock, I guess.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Somewhere.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
I guess we don't have anybody around here. Fix that clock.
See, Mr. Waghorn.
Maybe I can get a ladder and bring it out here tomorrow.
See, Mr. Waghorn looking. Maybe he can. Oh. Maybe he can take it.
Any other business before the council? Maze.
Maybe he can handle it for Twix 9 tomorrow.
Yeah, please. Thank you. We run a day behind here at the city government sometimes. Any other thing? Is there a motion to?
So moved, Mr. Chair.
And a second? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Ayes have it. Mittens.